Okay, my dear students. Now we are going to discuss respiration in plants. So first of all, we have to discuss introduction part. Okay, right? Anybody join? Okay, good. So in the introduction, they discussed they gave us certain number of questions before moving into mechanism of oxidation of a number of biomolecules. So before the mechanism of that, here, what are the biomolecules? What are the macrobiomolecules, microbiomolecules? Simply move towards organic chemical analysis. In the acid insoluble fraction or pellet part. Okay, so in that slurry part, a number of biomolecules are present. Polysaccharides, proteins, nucleic acids, and lipids. Okay, so carbohydrate, a respiratory substrate. Lipid, a respiratory substrate. Protein, a respiratory substrate. Okay, so these biomolecules are subjected to oxidation to release a considerable amount of energy. Okay, so in the introduction, what are the questions given? Breathing, they discussed. What is breathing? Do all organisms are able to breathe? That was the first question. What is breathing? Do all organisms, including microbes, are they able to breathe? All plants are able to breathe? What is breathing? Exchange of gases. And what is the relationship between breathing and respiration? And oxidation of food material? And all these questions are, looks like that they are disconnected, but definitely they are connected. Okay, so directly connected, but we are not able to understand that one directly. What is breathing? What is the respiration? Is it essential? Why respiration is essential? Yeah, definitely respiration is essential. Breathing is essential. Otherwise, there will be no oxidation of organic matter. Do all organisms are breathing? Is it required for all organisms? One more question. That depends on type of respiration present in that organism. If it is obligate, aerobe, O2 is mandatory, breathing is mandatory. And if breathing is present, what about the form of breathing? What are the structures? What are the parts in place to perform respiration? These are the questions. So all these breathing, respiration, and one more thing, digestion, oxidation of food material, all these are linked. And they are taking place in an orderly manner. And here, one more question. What about the source of energy? The source, ultimate source of energy is sunlight only. Okay? Right, hang on. Some people are taking left. Why? Wait, 1 minute, please. I have to take the screenshot. Where is it? Where is it? 1 minute. One more time now. Okay, come back. Okay, so definitely the source of energy is sunlight, and with the help of sunlight, photoautotrophs are able to synthesize food material. So photoautotrophs, this introduction part is very, very important. Photoautotrophs, and I will focus on electron transport system. I will give more explanation, elaboration, and I will take more time to explain electron transport system. I know most of the people are expecting electron transport system. Rest of the things are well known to you, but I promise you that I have to explain. I plan to explain entire respiration. Okay, so photoautotrophs, that is either bacterium, blue-green algal members, whatever it is, a plant, or any organism which is having chloroplast and able to perform photosynthesis. Definitely, the product of that one is carbohydrate. Carbohydrate. So the immediate product of photosynthesis is carbohydrate only. With the help of this carbohydrate, they are able to synthesize energy and other carbon skeleton also, precursors required for the synthesis of proteins, lipids, and other biomolecules. Okay, right? So on this carbohydrate, on this photoautotrophic plant, remaining organisms, rest of the organisms, what are the heterotrophs? According to food chain, this heterotroph is directly dependent on the photoautotroph. If it is directly dependent on photoautotroph, that is herbivore. Use ecology knowledge, herbivore. If it is indirectly dependent on photoautotroph, that is carnivore. Okay, so so-called heterotrophy is either herbivore, carnivore. So this is a flow of energy. Okay, right. So now again question. For oxidation of so-called materials, breathing is mandatory. Breathing is able to supply O2. Okay, and we will discuss this breathing in a prolonged way. Some questions are there, some objections are there. Okay, what are the respiratory structures or organs present in animals, and what are the structures present in plants by means of which exchange of gases possible? And one more thing, the flow of energy is from sunlight, so-called solar energy, photoautotroph, carbohydrate formation, heterotroph. So this transformation of energy is actually part of bioenergetics. Bioenergetics. This word was given under the heading, that is a living state, means a concept of metabolism. What is a dynamic state? Energy transformation. Okay, so link this knowledge with the biomolecules. Okay, right. So that's about a so-called source of energy, and what about the role of photoautotroph, and what about the product of photosynthesis. During this photosynthesis, what are the raw materials, particularly CO2 plus H2O? These are the chemicals, inorganic simple chemical components with the help of end product of light reaction convert into complex organic biomolecule, that is carbohydrate. And what about the fate of this carbohydrate? During respiration, is either completely or incompletely oxidized into CO2 and H2O. Okay, so CO2 H2O convert into organic molecule. During oxidation, carbon is oxidized into CO2 and some amount of H2O. Okay, right? Is it clear? Now, the question is, during respiration, what about the fate of C bond C? Okay, that is oxidized to liberate some amount of energy present in it. So during oxidation of any molecule, whatever the type of molecule, for example, here I'm taking glucose molecule. Okay, so during oxidation of either glucose or some other biomolecule, the energy liberated is in both heat form, heat and chemical energy. Chemical energy. Heat form means a physical, that is a physical form only. And what is that chemical form, energy currency of the cell, ATP molecule? Okay, right? So respiration is, or oxidation of organic biomolecules is stepwise process, slow process, gradually happening. It is one type of combustion. Combustion means burning. Actually, combustion is a physical process form. During combustion, for example, we are firing some wood. Wood is fired. During fire, what about the energy present in all those biomolecules released in the form of heat only? Heat energy, 100% heat energy. It's not a slow process. It's a very fast process, unlike a so-called respiration or not. Respiration or oxidation of organic matter is a slow, stepwise manner, gradually happening. Okay, so whereby enabling the system, means a biosynthetic machinery, to convert some amount of energy into ATP molecule. Okay, right? So that's about so-called introduction part. Next one, what about the rate of transportation of oxygen? Given one is actually, do plants breathe? Yes, we have to discuss. Do plants breathe? Okay. This one you can understand, no problem. Okay, so do plants breathe? Yes, definitely. Plants have to breathe. What is breathe? Breathing means exchange of gases. So in animals, respiratory organs are present. They are concerned with breathing, uptake of O2, inhalation of oxygen, and exhalation of CO2. In the case of obligate aerobe and some extent of facultative anaerobe also. We will discuss what are the organisms on the base of O2 requirement. And what about in the case of plants? In plants, yes, definitely plants have to breathe. Breathing is present. And what are the structures concerned with breathing? In plants, what are the structures? Okay, one that is well known to you, stomata. Okay, all aerial parts, epidermis of all aerial parts with the stomata, that is concerned with not only exchange of gases. What about the function of stomata is well known, the exchange of gases, and it promotes transpiration also. Next, second one, lenticel. Lenticels. Okay, lenticels. Main function, exchange of gases, and also promotes transpiration. Next, roots, pneumatophores. Add this one also, pneumatophores. Breathing roots. Okay, so they are not organs. These are not organs. Just consider them as structures only. They are not organs. They are not organs, just structures or some part. Don't consider that one as an organ. So with the help of stomata, lenticel, pneumatophores, they are breathing. Now the question is, for example, this is a tall plant. It's a tall plant, 100 meters or some whatever the length. It's a tall plant. So even the stomata, lenticel, and the pneumatophores are present, there is no respiratory system. System is absent. Is there a respiratory system? Even though they are having in plants, there is no respiratory system. Please mute. No respiratory. No respiratory system. Yet the question is, even though they are not having respiratory system plants, how do all these, how do all these plants are able to maintain O2 requirement? So question is, how do plants regulate better? How do plants regulate, please mute, regulate their O2 requirement, even though there is no respiratory system. Respiratory system is concerned with the transportation of oxygen, particularly exchange of gases and transportation also. Okay, so along the length of the plant, oxygen is maintained, even though they are not having respiratory system. So how do plants are able to regulate their O2 requirement? So we have to answer this question. This paragraph is, this part is very, very important. If they prepare question out of this one, generally this is most neglected area by most of the faculty and students also. So, okay. So what are the reasons explain now textbook? Reason 1, 2, 3, explain. First reason is, how do they are able to maintain O2 level even though respiratory system, which is concerned with the transportation of oxygen, there is no respiratory system. Reason one, each part is able to take care of its O2 requirement. Okay, generally oxygen is available in the environment, atmosphere. Okay, all of a sudden, total oxygen present in the environment disappears. What about all human beings and other have to approach the hospital? Recently you heard about it. What about oxygen supply, oxygen cylinders? Okay, and they transported a huge oxygen cylinders with the help of trains, aeroplanes, and ships also. That is the importance of O2 for obligate aerobe like human being. So each and every part is able to look after its O2 requirement. So that's why the demand for transportation. So demand for transportation. Demand for transportation of O2 is very less. Reason, each and every plant part is able to take up or able to regulate its O2 requirement. So that's why separate transportation system is not required. This is also one type of adaptation. Okay, so there is no great demand for transportation. Okay, and next one, second one. What about the rate of transpiration? Rate of respiration in plants. Okay, is very less when compared with the animals. Okay, so rate of respiration in plants is very less when compared with the animals. Continuously we have to breathe. In plants, even breathing is switched off for 1 or 2 or 3 hours. It can survive. But what about human beings? Are we able to survive if O2 is switched off or nose is switched off? Definitely we will die. That is a problem which we are facing now. But what about in the case of plants? Even though O2 is stopped, external supply, definitely the plant is able to survive. The reason is during photosynthesis, if it is oxygenic photosynthesis, O2 is evolved. So internally, O2 is maintained. Okay. What is respiration? Intake of oxygen, inhalation of O2 from the external environment, and release of CO2. That is respiration or not? So such a phenomena is very less here. Its probability means its rate of the reaction is rate of respiration is very less. Reason, each and every plant part is able to take care of its oxygen. Moreover, during photosynthesis, lot of oxygen is evolved, that is reserved there. Okay, next. Third one. Cells are organs which need oxygen. Cells are parts, are those which are in need of more oxygen, are exposed to or nearest to environment, nearest to or exposed to environment. Environment. So cells, tissues, okay, wait 1 minute, hang on. One minute, hang on, please. Somebody call me. Okay, so cells, parts, generally they are exposed to environment. And for that one, one example was given. For example, leaf. Leaf is very thin. And all the cells are in contact with the external environment and able to take up. Hello, please mute. Please mute. Mute and speak to somebody. Please mute. Okay, so leaf is very thin. Okay, so that leaf is a best example for cells, parts which are exposed to environment. They're able to take up the oxygen very easily. And for that one, one question was this. What about woody parts? For example, this is a transverse section of a stem. Okay, so in that woody stem, the central part is duramen. The duramen is 100% dead. Dead part or not? And around that one, sapwood is present. In the sapwood also, except parenchyma, remaining part is dead. So the centrally located one is a dead tissue. O2 is not required, no respiration. Only peripheral part is required. So that's why here, lenticels are present, lenticels. Lenticels, okay? So for this question, these are the answers, okay? The demand for oxygen is very less. Reason, each and every plant part is able to look after its O2 requirements simply. Even though they are not having respiratory system and there is no respiratory organ. These are not organ, just structures only. They are able to compensate for the absence of respiratory organs, okay? My dear students, from this day onwards, I think I'm expecting more strength. Okay. Thanks for joining the class. Please try to join the class. I will give some examples, some important areas. Okay. So keep in touch with the textbook and concerned faculty. Interaction is mandatory. By interaction, we'll get emergent properties. Classes attend kaledanukondi automatically manlo. ఒక నెగ్లిజెన్సీ స్టార్ట్ అవుతుంది, నేను ప్రిపేర్ అవుతున్నానా కావట్లేదు అని క్వశ్చన్ రైజ్ అవుతుంది అనమాట. ఆటోమేటికలీ ఇట్ లీడ్స్ టు లేజీనెస్, లెథర్జీ. ప్లీజ్ కీప్ ఇన్ టచ్ విత్ యువర్ రెగ్యులర్ క్లాసెస్ అండ్ ఫ్యాకల్టీ. ఆటోమేటికలీ యూ కెన్ రీడ్ ద కన్సర్న్ వన్. ఓకే, థ్యాంక్స్ ఫర్ జాయినింగ్. ఓకే, టేక్ ద స్క్రీన్ షాట్. రైట్, నెక్స్ట్ వన్. నౌ ఐ యామ్ అరేంజింగ్ ద బోర్డ్. Okay, already I told you, during respiration, what about the fate of energy? Energy is liberated in both heat form and chemical energy. So here respiration is a stepwise oxidation, gradual oxidation of C bond C. During this stepwise oxidation, some amount of energy is trapped in the form of a ATP molecule. So what about that energy currency of the cell? Okay, that energy currency of cell is, that is well known to you, ATP molecule. Actually, this ATP molecule is, what is this one? A nucleoside. Nucleoside triphosphate. Nucleoside triphosphate. Okay, so how many kinds of nucleoside triphosphates are there? They are well known to you. What are they? Not only ATP molecule, but also GTP, CTP, UTP. All these are nucleoside triphosphates. Go back to molecular basis of inheritance. What about the role of or importance of these nucleoside triphosphates? One, energy. Not only energy, but also substrates. In your textbook, substrate was given. What is that substrate? That substrate is nothing but nucleotides. Okay, if last two terminal phosphates are the more at the time of hydrolysis of ATP molecule, take one ATP molecule, ATP. ATP molecule plus one H2O molecule. Hydrolysis or digestion of H2O, ATP molecule, sorry. ADP, adenosine diphosphate, plus one inorganic phosphate, plus 7.6 kilocalories of energy. So here, what about the total number of phosphates removed here in this case? Only one inorganic phosphate. Okay, if one more is removed, definitely that is more than 7.6 kilocalories of energy. Okay, so in ATP molecule, what about the total number of phosphates? Three phosphates are present, attached by concerned ester bonds. If ester bonds are removed, considerable amount of energy is coming out of hydrolysis of ATP molecule. And out of ATP, GTP, CTP, UTP, TTP, only ATP is called as energy currency. Go back to amino acid biosynthesis. What about the source of energy at the time of activation of amino acid? ATP and GTP both are required. GTP involved. But in most of the cellular metabolic reactions, ATP is donor of energy. So that's why it is called as an energy currency of the cell. Okay, right? So that's about ATP molecule. So it is a nucleoside triphosphate. One minute, hang on. Good job. 32 now. Good. Right? Okay. So that is about energy currency of the cell. And I don't want to explain mitochondria. If you want to learn about and listen about, watch about mitochondria, look into my YouTube. Mitochondria was clearly explained under the heading, the cell unit of life. Okay. Next, during this respiration, what about the importance of respiration? What is the role of respiration? Importance of respiration. What is the role of respiration? This statement also very, very important. Okay. So here, major source of respiratory substrate. How many kinds of respiratory substrates are there? Four kinds. What are they? Carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, fats, and certain number of organic compounds. What is the role of importance of respiration? One, energy. And the second one is very, very important, synthesis of precursors required for synthesis of a number of biomolecules. Precursors for synthesis of precursors for synthesis of amino acids. Okay, that results in the formation of protein, proteins, lipids, and a number of organic acids. Okay, so this one is called as a carbon skeleton. So our body is constructed with proteins, lipids, and other organic compounds. For example, if you take a plasma membrane, chemically, what about a plasma membrane? Chemically, plasma membrane is with the lipids, proteins, cholesterol, polysaccharides, next lipids, cholesterol is one type of lipid. Okay, all these are carbon skeleton or not involved in the construction of the body, not only energy. So that's why respiration is called as last one, that is after completion of aerobic respiration, amphibolic pathway. So energy production means catabolism or not. And synthesis of precursors, this part. Precursors for carbon skeleton. This part is anabolism. Anabolism or not? Anabolic reaction. Hence the name amphibolic. So in that introduction part, what about the meaning? Maximum part of amphibolic pathway they discuss. Energy precursors means both catabolism and anabolism. Okay, so that is about importance of respiration. Okay, is it clear? Right, so this is about just introduction part only. And what about the number of kinds of respiratory substrates? Don't forget that one, and link that knowledge with organic chemical analysis, what we studied under the heading biomolecules. Okay, grinding of animal tissue, liver or plant tissue, trichloroacetic acid, acid insoluble fraction, acid soluble fraction, and acid insoluble fraction, acid, that is a pellet part, is with polysaccharides, carbohydrate, okay, proteins, lipids. Okay, so what are the kinds of respiratory substrates here given? Polysaccharides given, carbohydrates given, proteins given, lipids given, organic acids given. Go back to acid insoluble fraction, polysaccharides. Yes, respiratory substrate, carbon skeleton. Okay, so here, the end product, of course, you may question, at the end of photosynthesis, for example, photosynthesis complete, what about the immediate product, that is carbohydrate? During oxidation of a carbohydrate, they are able to produce energy and precursors for all these things. Okay, so all organisms are dependent on carbohydrate or not? Definitely. Okay, either directly or indirectly. So this is about just introduction part. Okay, is it clear? Now, what about mechanism of aerobic and anaerobic respiration? One minute, hang on, please. Now I'm going to erase the board. Very good, strength. Excellent. Very happy to see you, all of you. Okay, now I'm arranging the board. Okay, right. Now, mechanism of respiration. So take aerobic respiration, mechanism of aerobic respiration. Okay, so given statement of place of respiration, cytoplasm, mitochondria given. We'll see what are the areas where so-called respiration falls. We will discuss. Okay, so in the mechanism of respiration, the first one, aerobic respiration, first one is glycolysis. Glycolysis is also called as a glycolytic metabolism. Glycolytic. That is lytic. Glycolytic. It is also called as EMP pathway. And also called as hexose diphosphate pathway. We'll see what are they. Glycolysis. This is well known to you. Glycolysis. Glucose is cleaved into sucrose is cleaved into glucose and fructose. Hence the name glycolysis. Glycolytic. Lytic lysis. Okay. EMP. What about EMP? So three people worked on mechanism of glycolysis. They prepared a so-called glycolytic metabolism, metabolic pathway, one during which one glucose is cleaved into two pyruvic acids by three members. Who were they? Gustav Ebden, Meyerhoff, Parnas. Ebden, Meyerhoff, Parnas. They traced out the mechanism of a partial oxidation of glucose into pyruvic acids. And is the name EMP. Next, HDPP. H means hexose. Hexose, six carbon compound. Diphosphate pathway. Here, fructose 1,6 bisphosphate plays an important role in the formation of two pyruvic acids. Hence the name hexose diphosphate pathway. So glycolysis is also called as a glycolytic. That is glycolytic. And one more word. Please mute. To confuse you, glycolate metabolism. What is a glycolate metabolism? It is a C2 cycle. Please mute. C2 cycle, that is a photorespiration. Please mute, please. Okay, so this is a glycolate, that is a glycolytic lysis. This is a glycolate. Okay, don't get confused between these two. Distinguish it. Glycolytic, glycolate. This is different. Please mute. Hello, please mute, please. Please mute. So at the end of, leave me out, please. At the end, okay. So at the end of respiration, one statement was there: pure form of respiratory substrates. What about a pure form of a respiratory substrate? Pure form means not converted into monomers. So what about pure form of carbohydrates and so-called one pure form is nothing but that pure form of respiratory substrates one by one. First one is polysaccharides, polymer. So polysaccharides are not suitable for respiration or oxidation. Before that one, digestion is required. Polysaccharides, oligosaccharides. Oligosaccharide means that is also polysaccharide with a limited number of monomers. 5 to 10 monomers are present. Protein. Pure form of protein, not suitable for respiration. Lipid also. Lipids also. Digestion is required. Okay, so all these pure form of respiratory substrates must be subjected to digestion with the help of a concerned enzymes. What are they? One, carbohydrates. 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 Why I'm explaining like this? Go back to lysosomes. Lysosomes are rich in hydrolytic enzymes. So many hydrolytic enzymes given on that. Okay, so all those are concerned with the digestion and carbohydrates. So now we have to focus on invertase. According to our textbook, invertase or sucrase. That depends on type of the carbohydrate. Okay, oligosaccharide, sucrose. Protein, for protein, proteolytic enzymes. Proteases or proteolytic enzymes. Okay, lipids, lipases. Okay, right? So this part is a digestion part. Okay, so now they are converted into simple monomeric compounds. Okay, lipid is actually that is a one molecule only, but various functional groups are present. Okay, in the case of lipid also, even though it is a one lipid molecule, glycerol is one molecule only, there also digestion is required. Go back to a mechanism of digestion given in zoology textbook. Add that here, because I don't know what about the mechanism of emulsification, digestion of lipids. Use that knowledge here. Okay. So now all these molecules are subjected to respiration and oxidation of concerned monomers. And here, one more thing in the case of animals, these monomers are transported. Transported. Glucose is transported or not with the help of blood. But what about in the case of plant? Transportation of carbohydrate is always in the form of starch only, in the form of sucrose only. Use that knowledge. So in the case of animals, what about the end product of digestion? Glucose, fructose, amino acids. Okay, and other organic monomers. In the case of plants, always carbohydrates are transported in sucrose form only. Sorry for this one. Sucrose form only, not in the form of starch. That is wrong one. In the form of sucrose only. Okay. Otherwise, there is no meaning for pressure flow hypothesis, phloem transport, that which we studied. Okay. Right. So this is about last statement, pure form of respiratory substrates, not suitable for respiration. Now, what about a mechanism of glycolysis? Okay. Right. And what about the total number of reactions required for the conversion of one glucose molecule into two pyruvic acids? And what about the number of enzymes involved? Okay. And before that one, what about the fate of sucrose? Okay, so take one molecule of sucrose. So sucrose is disaccharide. Okay, that is a one type of oligosaccharide. And what are the monomers? I will give you just monomers. Glucose and fructose. And what is the bond between these two? The bond between glucose and fructose is 1,2-glycosidic linkage. Use your chemistry knowledge. Okay. So first carbon atom of glucose. First carbon atom of glucose. So first carbon of glucose linked to second carbon of fructose. Okay, so now it is subjected to digestion. Given enzyme is invertase, use that one. It is concerned with the hydrolysis, addition of H2O. This bond is formed by dehydration. So hydration, hydrolysis. Okay. So what are the monomers? They are well known to glucose, 6-carbon, and fructose, 6-carbon. So this one is a 12-carbon compound. Okay, is it clear? So there is about a digestion part, digestion of this one. Okay, so monomers are produced. Now these two are suitable for glycolysis. Okay, now what about glycolysis? This is a digestion part one. Okay, take the screenshot. So this pathway is common for both aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Common pathway. Okay, right? So what are the steps present in glycolysis? Okay, so glucose or fructose. Okay, so converted into glucose 6-phosphate. Okay, so first reaction is a phosphorylation. And that reaction is regulated by hexokinase. Hexokinase is old name of glucose 6-phosphotransferase. Okay. One minute, blur, fluctuations in net. Okay, hey, again, what is this nonsense? Right. Okay, so hexokinase is also called as a glucose-6-phosphotransferase. In 2019 or 18, they asked the type of enzyme involved in the first reaction of glycolysis, hexokinase. In Telugu Academy textbook, enzyme code also given. Enzyme code 2712. Use that knowledge also. And here, what about a number of ATP molecules consumed? One molecule of ATP. Actually, here H2 also, but it was not given, I think. ATP molecule, hydrolysis ADP molecule, and inorganic phosphate is added to 6th carbon atom. Hence the name glucose 6-phosphate. So this reaction is energy consuming reaction. Phosphorylation. Energy consuming reaction. What happened to this one? Okay. So this reaction is endergonic reaction. Endergonic reaction. This is one energy consuming reaction. Okay, right now, glucose 6-phosphate is converted into fructose 6-monophosphate. Okay, so this is a isomerization. Fructose isomerase. Okay, next. Fructose 6-phosphate is phosphorylated to fructose 6th carbon with 1-phosphate. Okay, fructose 1, 6th carbon with already phosphate. Here 1,6 by phosphate or diphosphate. So monophosphate is converted into diphosphate. 6th carbon with 1-phosphate coming from first ATP molecule. This one, first phosphorylation. And what about this one? One more second phosphate is added to fructose at which position? First carbon atom. Okay, so this is also energy consuming reaction. So this reaction is phosphorylation. And enzyme required is phosphofructokinase. You can write kinase, no problem. Actually, phosphofructokinase. Here, how many ATP molecules? Here also one ATP molecule. And this reaction also endergonic reaction. So what about the total number of endergonic reactions? One, fan sound. So total number of reactions, how many endergonic reactions? Two reactions, energy consuming reactions. Okay, so here one more ATP molecule, H2O also, ADP, inorganic phosphate added to first carbon atom. Okay, so fructose 1,6 bisphosphate is the main hexose from which 2 pyruvic acids are produced. Hence the name hexose diphosphate pathway. That is a fructose 1,6 bisphosphate. Okay. Now, what about the fate of this one? cleavage reaction, splitting reaction. Fourth one, cleavage reaction. Enzyme required is a triose phosphate isomerase. Aldolase enzyme. Okay. So one molecule of DHAP, one molecule of G3P. Okay, so better we'll take this reaction on the top, not here. Okay, so fourth reaction is cleavage by aldolase. Okay, so out of DHAP and G3P, G3P is suitable for biological oxidation. DHAP is not suitable for biological oxidation. So that's why DHAP is converted into G3P by triose phosphate isomerase. Triose phosphate isomerase. Okay. So what about the total number of trioses here? These two are trioses or not? Three carbon compounds. Okay, right? I'll leave it, no problem. So how many are available ultimately? Two molecules of G3P available. Okay, this is also called as a 3-PGAL, 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde. Okay. So 6 carbon into 3 carbon, 3 carbon. Is it clear? Okay. Right. So my dear students, today enough. Tomorrow, we will discuss what about the fate of two molecules of G3P and what about energetics of glycolysis. We will see that one tomorrow. Please, my request is, please attend the class regularly.
Hello, TVR, sir.
Madam.
TVR, sir, good afternoon.
Madam, good afternoon, madam.
It is happy to see nearly 35 students in your class today.
Yes, madam, because of you, madam.
Not me.
That statement was a really wonderful statement, madam. That script. Nice.
Krishna made calls to all the boys, and you know the boys responded today. Hello, madam. Boys. Can you hear me?
Yes, madam.
Yes, madam.
How are you, madam?
ఎన్ని రోజులు ఎక్కడికి వెళ్ళిపోయారు? టీచర్స్ ఎవరు గుర్తు రాలేదా? కాలేజ్ గుర్తు రాలేదా? అందరూ ఆరోగ్యంగా ఉన్నారా? ఇండ్లలో అందరూ బాగున్నారా? ఉన్నారు కదా, గుడ్. అది మెయింటైన్ చేయండి. ఫస్ట్
హెల్త్.
దెన్ ఇంకొకటి ఏంటి అంటే, బీ విత్ ద టీచర్స్. No, last time we had very bad experience. No, we failed to motivate. Of course, we made many attempts to motivate the students. In different ways we tried, but students were not cooperative, so they didn't excel in their exam actually. తర్వాత లాస్ట్ లో వాళ్ళు ఫీల్ అయ్యారు, మేడం మీరు చెప్పినట్టు మేము ముందే వచ్చింటే బాగుండేది, లేదు మేము విన్నట్టు బాగుండేది, మేము ఎగ్జామ్ మీ షెడ్యూల్ ఫాలో అయ్యింటే బాగుండేది అని వాళ్ళు తర్వాత ఫీల్ అయ్యారు. కనీసం వాళ్ళని చూసైనా మనము లెసన్ నేర్చుకోవాలి కదా. ఇంటి దగ్గర అనుకూలంగా ఉండదు చదవటానికి. ఇప్పటికీ ఎంతమంది పిల్లలు కాల్ చేసి మేడం కాలేజ్కి ఎప్పుడు పిలుస్తారు అని అడుగుతున్నారు. ఎందుకు అంటే ఇంటి దగ్గర చదివే ఎన్వైరన్మెంట్ ఉండదు. డెఫినెట్లీ మెనీ డిస్ట్రాక్షన్స్ ఉంటాయి, డీవియేషన్స్ ఉంటాయి. కానీ మరి మీరు మిమ్మల్ని మీరు మోటివేట్ చేసుకుంటూ ఈ 4 క్లాసులు అటెండ్ అయ్యి మిగతాది రెఫరెన్స్ కి మళ్ళీ సార్ వాళ్ళు వీడియోస్ పోస్ట్ చేస్తున్నారు. యు నో, వన్ రిక్వెస్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ అవర్ సైడ్ ఇస్ వీ వర్ వెరీ మచ్ డిసప్పాయింటెడ్ to see your attendance.